For two decades, two friends have organized kayak trips for devotees of Chesapeake Bay, from government officials to artists. Tom Horton is an award-winning Chesapeake Bay author. He teaches writing and bay studies at Salisbury State.
Trips like this are critical because they remind us that there's something out here worth fighting for, and there's some really good life left in this system.
Don Baugh is Vice President for Education at the Chesapeake Bay Foundation.
These trips connect you to nature, connect you to the Chesapeake, and they connect you to a place where the bay is wild and wonderful.
So bring my paddle. Always goes better with a paddle.
It does. It usually goes better with a paddle.
The adventurers cast off from the southern tip of Bishop's Head in Dorchester County, crossing the big waters of Hupper Straits. All day, they'll wind their way through salt marshes and camp for the night on the beach of disappearing Holland Island.
Any line for Holland, what's left of it.
We've got nice conditions for this.
Oh, we're gonna blow across the straits here.
This particular trip, which really connects the islands of the Chesapeake, I think is the finest trip of the bay. If you had to put a pinprick on a map and say we're supposed to remote part of the Chesapeake, it'd be within a quarter mile where we are right now.
Probably so, yeah. We're getting across here. Looks like a damn good place to hit a fish.
They've gotten the Navy's permission to explore the canals, or guts, of Bloodsworth Island. Out come the fishing poles. They've challenged themselves to fish for their dinner.
Fish on!
Yeah, it's bait-sized.
Fish off! Rockfish and crabs are great icons for the Chesapeake. For about 30 years, we had no rockfish. And rockfish came back. And now with a well-managed fishery, we've got lots of rockfish. The rockfish is a symbol, basically, I think, that the bay can come back.
A lot of grass in here.
Is there? Think it's eel grass? Look here, come over here. Yeah, see, this is the big right turn we took. We're headed up here, and see, I think it's
the changing meanders of these mysterious marshes can fool even the experienced eye. But you could say these explorers have been mindfully lost in the bay for years, dedicating their lives to preserving and restoring its one-of-a-kind riches.
About half of the natural productivity on the planet comes from a few percent of the planet, and that few percent tends to be around edges, wetlands, seagrasses, coral reef, mangroves, of those big world-class natural systems. The Chesapeake has two, wetlands and seagrass meadows. So, you know, we're talking really world-class natural resources here.
Emerging from the maze of marshes, the kayakers cross big waters again to set up camp on Holland Island.
Last house on Holland there.
A century ago, Holland Island was a thriving waterman's community. Erosion and sea level rise are relentlessly washing it away. The landmark last house is poised to fall at any time, a symbol of the bay's precarious future. Nesting pelicans, eagles, and other wildlife will be orphaned when the island finally slips beneath the waves.
You know, the bay has got a different beauty than other places. To me, there's a real beauty of the color, the beauty of the landscape, the flatness and the texture of it. There's also kind of a beauty of the bounty of nature, which is that you're surrounded by life here.
It's just being here. It's a feeling. It's the sight, the smell, all of it is unique to this area.
Ed Dryden's ancestors settled on the eastern shore in the 1700s. The bay then must have looked a lot like it does here, now.
I've kayaked all over the world, and this is special.
I really come for this sacred place. It's amazing to think that we're only 35 miles from Washington, D.C.
Jeff Horan has taken these trips for over 5 years. Day job, Director of Watershed Services, Department of Natural Resources.
And you see its various layers. You know, you see the salt cord grass and then the tall cord grass, and then you have the loblolly pines behind it. But we're losing this system because of sea level rise, because of the development for all these things. And to have this still here like this, it is kind of a magical place.
This is the heart of the heart of the bay. But when you're out here, it's a really great opportunity just to wallow in it, just to always be in it.
David Harp is a professional bay photographer. He's collaborated with Tom Horton and others on celebrated books about the Chesapeake.
I love this place, and I want to show what's at risk. And what I always strive for, and going back to these places, is not what it looked like, but what it felt to be there.
At the sunset witching hour, they easily catch their dinner, rockfish. Ideas spark by the fire. It's abundant sustenance for the body, mind, spirit. Next morning, the adventurers head south again to Smith Island, Maryland's iconic waterman's community, a unique bay culture dying with the decline of oysters and blue crabs.
The pollution that is killing Chesapeake Bay comes from how we eat. Our agriculture pollutes how we heat and cool, power plants, how we transport ourselves, automobiles, how we house ourselves, sprawl development, cutting forests, paving parking lots. The answer is not for humans to go away, but we have to learn how to feed ourselves without screwing up the water. We have to learn how to transport ourselves without trashing the environment. We have to figure out how to house ourselves. And that probably is going to mean figuring out how many people this region can handle.
My fear of the Chesapeake Bay is it's going to be gone before people fully realize the extent of the damage. And of course, once it's gone, it's gone.